So explain how this works. It doesn't seem to be advertising driven in the way that most of Vox is. What's the business here for you?
Well, happy to announce first day of the NFL regular season today that we're creating a great service for sports fans. I don't have to tell you and your audience that sports betting and interest in it and interest in daily fantasy is at an all-time high, expected to grow even more as it becomes legal in more states. DraftKings is a leader in providing the actual gameplay, whether it's DFS or increasingly more in the sports betting space. And we're the leader when it comes to creating content about things that sports fans are passionate about. So the simplest idea is let's come together and create great content, you know, not only for people who bet and play, but even if you don't, like you're curious, you want to know what the lines are, you want to know who the favorites are, you want to know what the prop bets are. So we're going to create original content based on the ethos and the tone of SB Nation, which hits about 65 million people every month, a leader in the sports community space, lend our expertise, Vox Media's technology, and DraftKings' leadership in their space. The business model is going to be continuing. Actually, we are going to have advertising. What DraftKings and we are seeing is that not only do people love to play these games, but marketers love to get in front of people who play these games. And so I think together we can kind of help solve a problem for them, which is to leverage our scale and expertise and our technology and together create a great service for sports fans.
But it's not mostly advertising based, I take it. I mean, they're paying you, right, to produce the content that helps draw eyeballs?
We're going to sell advertising to marketers. Uh-huh. And, of course, they're in the game business, and so they're going to get new customers as well.
All right, so I'm going to borrow a question that was a headline from a Recode article on Vox back in February. How long before big media companies become big sports gambling companies? I ask you that question with this news today.
Yeah, well, you know, we're not, Vox Media is not going to get in the sports gambling business. That's a regulated business. That's what DraftKings is really good at. Our partner over there, Ezra Kuharj, came to me with this idea. But you're absolutely right. Like I saw an announcement with Fox. We see ESPN. We see other players, media companies getting into the space. So I think absolutely the marriage of media and sports gaming together is a powerful one. And I think it's best done when companies like ours stick to what we do well, which is create great content, create big communities, draw big audiences, have advertising solutions, and companies like DraftKings do what they're a leader in.
There's a plethora of content already out there for the average sports fan online. So what will distinguish your content in terms of why and how it services this particular segment, which you're talking about, as sort of somebody who's more likely to bet on a game?
Well, SB Nation has always been unique. We call ourselves more fan-focused. What it means from a business perspective is we're not only are we always like among the top five, along with, say, ESPN and Yahoo in terms of reach, but we're the only ones that are not affiliated with a sports league. We don't have rights deals where we have to cover things in a certain way. We can be true to the fan philosophy and what the fans really care about. We're not part of a big media conglomerate. We're not a sports league ourselves. So what that enables from an editorial perspective is to speak honestly, to cover things in the way that fans really want to talk about, to dive deep into communities. Our network is different than others. We're not just one brand. We have the leading sports community for every team. So if you're here in New York and you're a New York Giants fan, you might know us as Big Blue View. But if you're out in California and you're a San Francisco 49ers fan, you know us as Niners Nation. Both of those are leading communities. So that's another distinction. It's not just talking to all sports fans with one voice. It's talking to you and your passion.
How tough is the digital advertising market right now? I mean, there were a couple years ago efforts to build on Facebook. You know, The Verge was working on some things along those lines. There was this move toward, you know, video in advertising, which seemed to work well for a while, but now seems to be getting kind of constricted. How tough is the business?
Well, you've noted that there's always change. And I think every single industry is being impacted by technology. You have to be on your toes. You have to be ready for change. Media more so than any others. Having said that, for companies like ours, that we're now well over ComScore around the 100 million uniques size, and for companies like ours, we're seeing that the combination of scale and quality matters. I do think it's tougher for smaller companies that might be subscale. And, you know, you see that happening with local news, unfortunately, providing a vital service, but really struggling with the business model. So you see change everywhere. I think it's particularly having impact on the subscale players.
Is that a consolidation call?
I think it is a consolidation call. I mean, I'm not saying anything that hasn't been said before, but we see it happening. You know, we've acquired two smaller companies ourselves this year, and I think we'll continue to be on the lookout for organic investment, partnership, and M&A activity.